tell you is, I want each one of you in proper school uniform. Okay? Beta, don't consider this as a virtual class. Consider it as an actual class. Only then you will be able to gain more out of this class. Okay? So we are all meeting here together. Don't think we are meeting virtually. See that all of you can see each other. Okay? It would be, obviously, it would be much better if you are all properly dressed in your uniforms, smartly dressed. Fine? So I need each one of you to be properly dressed in your school uniform. Okay? So please remember all the instructions. First thing, you have to be on time. Second thing, you have to maintain the discipline in the same way as you were there in the class. If you will be creating some kind of mischief, some kind of nonsense, I will have to remove you from the class. And if I remove you from the class, you know, you won't be able to attend the class again. Right? So don't create problems for yourself. We are here for helping you learn something. So beta, please make sure that you are all sincerely attending the classes. One more thing which I need to tell you is that I would not permit eating and lying down and all in the class. Okay? You have to be careful, beta. Please, again, I reiterate on the same thing. Don't feel it's a virtual class, okay? You are not drinking or eating in the actual class. Please, same way, behave in this class also. Now, again, I am putting on my mask. If you could please let me know, am I still audible clearly? You can give me a thumbs up if I am audible clearly. You can all hear me clearly. Very good. Excellent. Thank you so much, all of you. I'm really happy all of you joined together today. Okay? So, beta, today we are going to start a new session for you. Okay? This is the new session for class 6 from primary. You all have come to the middle section. It is actually a kind of big promotion for you all. But again, this promotion comes with equal sense of responsibilities also. You should be more responsible about your studies. You should be more sincere. Okay? So, today we are going to start revising some previous concepts which will be applicable in this class also. So we already know that we are going to a critical situation. So we were not able to learn the things in the way they actually could have been, right? So for making things better for you, for making things easier for you, we are revising some previous concepts so that when you understand the new things, you are able to understand them well. Okay? I hope I am clear. If there are any doubts, you can still type in the chat. Alright? So, okay. And there are so many children who have not switched on their videos. Beta, I want to see all of your faces. See, I am now wearing mask on you. That should be my face. Because you should know your teacher. Same way, I should also know my students. All of you, please switch on the videos. Very good. Excellent. Very good. Very nice. Who's this? Del, Nandini, switch on the videos. Ridhima Hara, Anshika Chattar, Vishal Jain. Beta, please, all of you, switch on the videos. Great. So happy to see all of you. I welcome you all to the new session of class 6 and we are going to study maths. Okay? Okay, so, Peter, first of all, I will start with the most basic thing. What is the most basic thing about maths? It's about numbers. How we know the numbers, how do we read the numbers, right? So, that is the most basic thing. I know you have done it in class 4, class 5, but now, again, I'm reiterating because we will be going to the next higher level very soon. Okay? So, when we name the numbers or when we read the numbers, suppose, what is this? This is 396. Right? He writes as 396. What is this? 3,967. What is this? 39,674. Till this you have done. Now we move on to a bit higher level. What is this? How do I name the word? Name the numbers. We have two different systems for that. First one is the Indian system, and second one is the international system. Okay? You would have realized that we use the word lakhs, crores, right? We use that in the Indian system, but internationally they don't use lakhs, crores. Instead, they use millions, billions. Fine? This much I think you would have heard. Out of, you know, like you see in your daily life, whatever you hear in the TV or and all. So you know that Indian and international are different systems for naming the numbers, right? So first of all, we will start with the Indian system, right? We are Indians, so we will first try to learn about how is our system of naming the numbers, all right? So in Indian system, we have ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, lakhs, and 10 lakhs. I'm not going beyond that. Okay, beyond it will be good. I think most of you will know about it. But here we are only discussing about this. So, if I talk about, let's say, this number, I will start from my immediate right. First digit is the ones. Okay, second will be the tens. Ones, tens. Third one will be 100. Then fourth one is thousands. Then 10,000. After that it will be lakhs. Then 10 lakhs, and then crores will be. Okay. So how are we going for it? We are going from the right. Ones, I'm repeating myself. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, lakh, 10 lakh, and crores. Okay? Before I move further, there is one more thing which I need to tell you. Most of you right now, I can see, just sitting without your pen or pencil in their hand. Because we are doing maths. Okay? This is not history, or this is not English, and you will listen to the stories and you will understand. Okay, you have to practice maths. Fine. So what will we do from tomorrow onwards? We will always have a rough notebook and a pen or a pencil with us. Okay? Whatever ma'am gives us, whatever I will give you or the other teacher gives you, or probably solve on the board, you can also try and solve it simultaneously in your notebook. That is how you learn maths, okay? Fine, so from tomorrow onwards, I should see all of you, okay? I see so many of you are showing me your notebooks. Very good, excellent. But tomorrow onwards, everybody will have it, okay? So, if you have your notebooks and pens, you can note this down. This is how we name the numbers if it is the Indian system, okay? Now, let's just take one example. I take one example. Alright, now I will try to name this. Okay? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, see where is this? Okay, where is this heading group? So this is heading group roles. I have seen that. So now I will name my number. It is 1 crore. Now this is 10 lakhs and lakhs. So it will be 23 lakhs. After that it is 10,000 and 1,000, so it will be 45,000. After that we have 600 and 78. All right. So it is 1,23,45,678. All right. So I have named my number. Now, beta, I am giving you a small task. You will write any 8-digit numbers, 5 numbers of your own choice. Okay? 5 numbers of your own choice you will write, and those will be 8-digit numbers, and you will try to name them according to the Indian system of naming the numbers. Is that clear? So tomorrow when we meet, I will ask you to show the copy where you have done those 5 numbers. Understand? I hope I'm clear. Very good. So many of you are showing me thumbs up. Great. Who's this? Arav Sharma, beta, are you listening to music? Or are you listening to ma'am? I see you dancing here. No problem. Okay, let's continue. Fine. I hope you are clear with the Indian system of naming the numbers. Just to reiterate, I will give you one more example. Okay? And that I will not write. We will all do it together. We will do it together. Fine? Alright, let's start. You will count with me, okay? You will all count with me. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, crores. Right? So that means we have to do it in crores. Understand? So what will we write? All of you say with me, what will you write? 7 crores, right? After that, lakhs, may hamare paas kuch hai? No, we don't have anything in lakhs. We have only zeros. So we will skip that. 7 crores. After that, what will that be? Say that. 70,000, right? 7,70,000. Again, hundreds ke place mein there is a zero. So 7 crores, 70,000 and 70. Have you got the same answer? All of you, beta, have you got the same answer? If you still find it confusing, no problem. Just write the little bit, likh lo. Agar aapko confusion hota hai, little bit, likh lo. And in numbers where you have a lot of zeros like this, you should write. Okay? So if you write here, na, so you will understand. See, here I know that 100 place there's a zero. So 100 ka number te jaana. After that, 1,000 and 10,000, dono 1,000 mein aake hai, to 70 hai. Fine. Now lakhs and 10 lakhs. Dono mein zero hai. I know ki lakhs wala koi term nahi aayega because lakhs dono zero hai. And then I have crores. Understand? That is how we name the numbers. Okay, don't get confused. Now, when you write those 5 numbers of your own choice, please make sure you include zeros in it. Zeros at every place. Okay? That means you will be able to understand the concept better. You are creating your own questions and then your own solutions. Fine. All right. Next, we come to the international system of naming the numbers. So, the international system how does it go? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000. After that, Indian we have lakhs. Here we will have 100,000. Okay, after 100,000, what we have next? We have million. Million, after that, 10 million. What would be next? Say, what would be next? It would be 100 million. So do you see Indian system, sorry, international system, it goes accordingly with three pairs of three. 1 10 100, then 1,000 10,000 100,000, 3 4,000, then 3 4 million. If we move further, we will be having billions, and again we have 3 4 billions. Billion, 10 billion, sorry, billion, 10 billion, and 100. Fine. So beta, whenever you have got a number and you have to name it, first of all, say according to which system you have to name it, because accordingly we will put the commas. Suppose this is the number, I am writing it twice. Okay, one time we will put commas according to the Indian system, and one time according to the international system. Let's say this one is the Indian system. So how will I put commas? First of all, 3, and after that pairs of 2. 2, 2. Understand? You move from the right, first we have 3, then 2, 2 the pairs. Alright? And here, always 3, 3 coming. Here, here. Understand? Now let's start, try to name this one according to the international system. Okay? You will all count with me and you will see that till what unit are you reaching? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, 100,000, million, 10 million. Understand? So we are reaching till 10 million. So what will this become? 12 million. Then 345,000. 345,000. Yeah, after that 678. I hope you are able to understand this. Now we had that difficult example of equals for a number. We will try it with the international system now. Okay, the same number. Right. Let's now try to name it according to the international system. I start counting from here. Yes. What is this? Ones. Then we have tens. Then we have 100. After that, 1,000. 10 million. Fine, so we are reaching till 10 million. Can we put commas? How do we put commas in the international system? In pairs of 3 moving from the right. So from here, comma, 1, 2, 3, comma, that's it. Got it? Now let's name it. What will this be? This will be 70 million. After that, 100,000 number mein hai apne paas. Hamare paas 10,000 mein 70 hai. So what will I write? 70 million
commas.
All of you remember? So, I will count from here and tell what you need to do. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, 100,000, 1 million, 10 million, and 100 million. So we have reached 100 million. So how will I write? 100 and 1 million. Kya million mein yahi aa raha na? 101. So 101 million. And what about the thousands? There is no 100 space for thousands here. I have only 10. So I will write 10,000. Right? And after that, 101. Because due to limited space, I am not writing it in one sentence. You have to write it in one sentence. Okay? If the sentence is full, only then you can move on to the next sentence. Fine? So, this is how I have named it according to the international system. But I hope things are clear and they will be more clear if you practice. Okay? So, please take these classes very seriously, very good. I can see some children showing me their copies. Excellent, Peta. Very good, Virat. Shabash. Excellent. Very nice here. I have Anshpal. Very good. Very good, Peta. Fine. So, tomorrow I will see your copies whether you've done 5 examples for each or not. Okay? Then we will move on to the next topic. Now, I'll just take a second to take your attendance. All of you, please stay here. Don't leave. Okay? Let me just take your attendance. Alright, so I've taken the attendance. Now, all of you please practice whatever you've done. Tomorrow I'll see you again. Same time, but be ready with your copies and pens, okay? I might ask you to solve some questions. Alright, so just take care.